So, hey, you guys, I'm back. And as you guys know, today we will be trying out the stocking cap method to see which one is going to work or whatever. Now, as you guys see, I had that brown stocking cap that was like a little too dark for my skin tone. So I decided to go with the lighter one. Now, with this one, I'm just outlining my hairline, basically, you guys, so you can see exactly where you would need to be putting the hair gel. Now, today I'm going to be using Got to Be Glued Glam Force. No, this is not sponsored. I just like using this one over the black one. But you know, both the black one and this one works for me. The yellow one, I never really tried that one, but those two do work for me. Now with this, I'm actually going to take the brushes that I use to dye my hair with and put that on my hairline. It's so much more easier to do it this way. And also, make sure the stocking cap is over your ears, that way it's not, like, you know, in the way. And then we're going to go ahead and take our blow dryer and blow dry this till it's like almost daggone dry, but you have to do it on a cool setting. Now with doing this gel, it, you know, took about 15 to 20 minutes to dry, and then I'm gonna go ahead and do the second layer. I'm not like really packing it on, you guys, though, because you have to realize that we're gonna be doing multiple layers, and those layers have to dry before you put the next one, otherwise the whole thing is gonna be like a big clumpy sloppy mess. So this is round two with using a Got to Be sculpting gel. Then next, I'm gonna go ahead and use the Glam Force hairspray. Now this has a really good hold to it, and I like using this because it kind of quickens the process of the wet gel. So yeah, here we go.
Let me cut the script. This shit be taking the long, I'm gonna let y'all know right now, this takes a long time to dry. Like a long time to dry. Like it took me like 35 minutes to get it to dry. Like seriously, and the shit is like still not dry. So I don't know what's going on. We're gonna have to see, because the bitch is taking hella long to dry.
But as you guys see, like I said, it was taking a very long time to dry. But once it was completely dry, you see the way it looks. It just looks really like matte, but a little bit shiny. Now I'm going to go ahead and take my hair scissors. You can use regular scissors, it doesn't even matter. But I'm just going to go ahead and cut the stocking cap off. Now with doing this, be careful not to cut your baby hairs. Also, make sure you can get as close as possible to the part of the stocking cap that's dry. Like those little light pieces, those are like just extra stocking cap that's not even gelled down, you know? So you have to cut all those off. If not, when you put the wig on, you're actually going to be able to see that line of demarcation. So you're going to have to like cut it off. And that's why I was trying to take my time and actually sit there and cut it off. And I'm sure I probably cut a baby hair too, I'm not even going to lie. But hey, I ain't got much hair in no way. So, you know, it's cool for me to start over. But if you got some hair, you need to kind of watch yourself, because you cut them edges right on off. But I just try to get as close as possible. And then next, I try to take a cotton swab, and I'm actually gonna go ahead and clean up around the edges so it's not no hair gel like in my way. Now this is the wig I'm actually gonna be using. It's from Wig Encounter. Now this is a full lace wig. It has 130% density in the front and 150% density in the back. But I'm not even gonna lie, I wish it was more density in the back, to be honest. But neither here or there. Basically, you guys, I was looking at the stocking cap on my scalp and everything, and it looked a little bit too white to me. Like the other one I still feel like was too dark, but this one is still a little bit too light for me. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is take my Fenty foundation in the color 350, and I'm actually gonna go ahead and put that on the stocking cap. Now I'm not one to really do this all the time, because I don't really like having makeup on when I take my facial makeup off, but hey, I needed it to look right. I wasn't trying to look like my scalp was out here ashy, okay? Now this is going to be round three and the final step of using the Got to Be glue. Now, well, gel. Now with doing this, I'm actually going to put it on, then I'm going to let it get a little bit tacky. Once it gets a little bit tacky, which means, you know, it's not completely dry, that's when I'm going to start the application of the wig. Do not dry it completely or you're not going to be able to put it on. So now I'm just going to take it piece by piece and then try to like be really careful and try to match it up with the same hairline of the actual wig cap. Now, with doing this, you kind of see, honey, she's giving is a scalp. She's looking is a natural. You know, she's doing what she's supposed to be doing. So, you know, Glamazante is very, very, very satisfied. Now, just be really careful. Take your time. You know, you might have to work at this. You might have to add a little bit of glue in certain portions.
So, hey, you guys, this is like the end result of my hair. Okay, so one thing I can say is Indian Body Wave has become like my most favorite hair of all time now. Like, I love Indian Body Wave. It's so soft. It has a pretty luster to it. It's just beautiful. It's just beautiful. Another thing is I didn't really want to do no baby. This piece of hair is like irking. Another thing is I didn't really want to do no baby hairs today. Like, I'm just kind of getting over the little baby hair look. So I just like the natural look when it's, you know, pulled back and whatnot. But as far as my hair, it took me a little bit of time to get it, but I feel like now that I've done it, I kind of know some mistakes and things that I was making throughout the whole process. I'm sorry I had to get off camera to like really lay it down, because I needed to get to my mirror and I'm not using a mirror. So I had a little mirror, but I just really had to like press her and lay her down. Now, I'm not even gonna lie, I feel like I could have plucked my frontal a little bit more, but I don't feel like it looks entirely too fake, like, you know what I mean? Like, I might try this method again, like master it after I keep practicing, but I don't know, y'all. So let me know what you guys think about the hair. It is a little wet, and the back is not as wet, but it is a little bit wet, so you know, whatever. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you're interested in this wig, the information will be in the bio, so definitely check that out. But for my first time, let me just tell you, I think that the method does work, but this is not a method where like you do your hair and then you go somewhere. No, like, this is like a 2 to 3 hour process for me, honestly, because I had to take my time, make sure everything was correct, and that's including with the frontal plucking and all the other stuff. But you guys, this top is actually on my website right now if you're currently interested into it, as well as these rings. I have them on my website too, so don't forget to shop on my website. Like I said, I'm about to head out now. I'm gonna wear this and then I'm gonna actually remove it later, and then I'm gonna show you guys the removal process and stuff like that. So with that being said, you have to definitely stay tuned, and I'll let you know what I think about it as an overall.
Okay, mommies, I'm back. Now, I wore it all day. Everything worked really good. It was very secure. Nobody knew that, you know, is a wig. Everybody thought is a scalp. And now I'm in the shower giving you, know, sexy realness. I didn't put anything on it. Literally, I just got into the shower and just kind of moved it around with my hands, and it slipped right on off. So it was pretty much a really easy method. It just, I sped it up, but it took a little bit of time to get it off just because of the simple fact that it actually was like layers of it, and I took it off the same exact day. But other than that, everything worked. I hope you guys enjoy. I'll see you in my next one. Mwah. See ya.